Scooby looks like shit.
I've heard this comment a lot, and I thought it was worthwhile discussing. First of all, let me say, I don't care a rat's patootie how you think I look. All that matters is that I am happy with my health, my strength, and my level of fitness, and I am. I'm quite proud of it. Thank you very much. You should be more worried about achieving your goals for health, physique, and fitness rather than worrying about what I look like. Second, I look like shit compared to who? The hordes of fake natties who dominate the men's physique? Yeah, I look like shit compared to them. And they can't go up a flight of stairs without huffing and puffing because they're out of breath. I look like shit compared to the pro bodybuilders who do gallons of steroids. Yeah, I do. But I wouldn't trade them bodies for the world. They're near death. I look like shit when compared to 20-year-olds. Duh. They're 20. A lot of people who make this comment that I look like shit have no concept of age and what age does to the physique. I am very close to 60. In other words, I'm roughly the age of the grandfather that most people are comparing me to. Because they'll list 20-year-old men's physique people and say, you look like shit compared to him. It's like, yeah. Now I know right about now, someone's gonna chime in and say, God, Scooby's in horrible shape. He's puffing and huffing. He can't even breathe. He's so out of shape. I'm going up a mountain, you ignoramus. I'm going up 3,500 feet vertical, and I'm on a 9% grade right now. So yeah, I'm huffing and puffing. So if you want to compare my physique to someone's, asking your grandfather to lift his shirt, because I'm probably about his age. So let's talk a little about old folks like myself and gaining muscle through lifting weights. Can someone who's 60-year-old gain muscle? Sure, but only if they've never lifted before. If you take someone like myself who's been lifting for 35 years, I reached my natty limit like 15 years ago, there's no way I'm gonna gain muscle. In fact, I work out harder than ever just to keep from losing muscle and strength, and I still do. Now there's one aspect of getting older that very few people can escape, and that is skin tone. As you get older, your skin becomes less elastic, which means wrinkles. So, for example, on me, I can't point out because I have one hand on the steering wheel and one on the camera, but below my belly button in the lower abs, I have wrinkles there. I can stretch so that they're not there, but if I'm just normal, there'll be slight wrinkles. To sides of the pecs sometimes, obviously under the chin, I have wrinkles. That just comes with age. And, you know, very likely when you're 60, you're gonna have those too. So look forward to it.
Scooby looks like shit.
Let me summarize. First of all, I don't care what you think I look like. Second of all, what's most important is that I am happy with where I am. I'm happy with my health, happy with my strength. I'm happy with my cardiovascular conditioning. I'm happy with my endurance, happy with my health, happy with my life. What you should be more concerned about is, are you happy with where you are? If not, why are you wasting time criticizing others about their physique and health instead of working on your own? Seriously, 60-year-old natties do look like shit when compared to 20-year-old fake natty physique stars. Just the way it is. Thanks for watching. Auf Wiedersehen.
Say this in Scooby's voice. Scooby looks like shit. Scooby is fat. Scooby's chest is way overdeveloped. developed. Scooby has droopy skin. Scooby's head is too small. Scooby's legs are too small. Scooby's neck is too small. Scooby's abs look weird. Scooby isn't symmetrical. Scooby should work out legs. Scooby has saggy muscles. Scooby is ugly. Scooby's pecs are too big. Scooby has a crooked back. Scooby has a big nose. Scooby has big nipples. Scooby has boobies. Ah! Scooby doesn't have abs. Scooby's skin is too red.